Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you for joining me. Here's a current update. What's going on at Yellowstone? Kind of like the magician, you're distracted by the one hand while they're pulling something with another. Well, that's kind of what's going on with Yellowstone when they're talking about the uplift that's going on at Old Faithful. Here we have a map that is provided by the Nevada Geodetic Laboratory GPS network station of Yellowstone. Down over here is Yellowstone Lake. Up over here is Hedgen Lake. And they've been talking about the uplift that's been going on at Old Faithful. Said it's been going on since July. We have a history of the uplift for Old Faithful going back to 2004. That's when they started keeping track of what's going on. The red line, I guess, is general trends, and you can see at certain points in time. Oh, between 2008, 2010, there was uplift. And 2016, let me show you this. We'll make it bigger for you. And I'll pull it over. Yeah, kind of like the magician distracting you with his right hand when you should be looking at the left, or vice versa. So here we have 2021 going up, tracking until next year, and we're close to that. And it's going up a little tiny bit, centimeters. So after going through all the data for all the monitors, I noticed over here by Hedgen Lake, Madison River area, this is the area of the last eruption, this area right here, the lava Creek Tuff. And in truth, this is where we've been having the earthquake swarms. Yeah, there was another one today, but they're not reporting all the earthquakes. And this is actually the area the uplift is occurring. This too is the area of the last eruption, the last super eruption, when it unzipped, making a counterclockwise rotation as it unzipped and, yeah, created that huge eruption, oh, about 630,000 years ago. So let's take a look what's going on there at these monitors. Okay, station P712. And this is measured in millimeters. For a while there was no data being brought in. But as of this year, if we go from, let's take an average from this line right there, and we'll bring it over. Okay, minus 10, which was sometime last year, all the way up here to this top line, which is probably 40 millimeters of uplift within the last year. So that would be about 1.6 inches. This is the Madison River area according to the coordinates of what they give us. All right, so let me close that out and I'll go to another one. That was that one right there. Let's go to this one right here. P457. This area has been steadily climbing since 2008 when they first started watching it. Let me bring it down so you can see the year. 2020 and this year. So it has risen. Let's bring it over. Probably about, bring it over a little bit farther. Maybe 15 millimeters. So that area has risen about a half an inch. If I go from the average, you know, in the middle here. That is north of Hedgen Lake. So let's go down here south of Hedgen Lake. And we got uplift also. And you can see it's been steadily growing since 2006 when they first started watching it. That one too. All of a sudden, this year, it started going up. That one's not working. More so for the Madison River area. Now, this is also near West Yellowstone. after going down to about 2014, 2016, it's been steadily climbing. And it's gone up. They got it marked in blue. That would be this year. Last year. Let me bring it over for you. So they are watching this. And it's probably risen about 20 millimeters since last year. They have here Midas value 1.32 plus minus 0.60. So that's probably gone up 25 millimeters. Not quite 1 inch. Again, this is Old Faithful. So if you compare that with these other sites, see, we got small uplift here. This is the area through here where the uplift is going on. Let's try this one here. Uplift. Not a lot, but this is the area where the earthquake swarm is happening, where the uplift is occurring. Yeah, that one's not working properly either. Stopped working. All right, let's find another one. See, going down. Where the hot spot that they claim, Bob Smith believes will be the area of the next eruption. And no, in fact, that is not what is happening. See, steady. Let me bring this over. Yellowstone Lake. This is the area of the last eruption, and this is the area where the uplift, as small as it is occurring. The area for Hedgen Lake is measured in 10 millimeters. We've got uplift going on. Is that one working? Yeah, that one's working. See, the farther out I go from this location, the less uplift there is. Let me see if I can get that to work. See, farther south, trend going down. No, this is the area where the uplift is happening. Let's look at this one again. Oh, that one's not working. Let's look at that one. There you go. See, uplift all of a sudden. Almost as high as it was in 2014. A paper from 2015. For smaller eruptions, Yellowstone can wake up quickly. These small eruptions are still about the size of the largest eruption the world has seen in the last century, like Mount Pinatubo. So how much warning can we expect for them? They did a study of the different crystals, and they found that in 3 of the 4 crystals, there were actually no change in magnesium concentrations across the boundary. Since magnesium is the fastest, it could have smoothed away the difference in about 10 years. The 4th crystal, however, on the other hand, apparently came out of the oven after 10 months or so. So a new magma was mixing in, creating these crystals, and they were only in the caldera for about 10 months. Since all 4 crystals existed in the same eruption, it could be that there were 2 rejuvenating pulses of hot magma before the lid was blown off. But just after a handful of months or years, after fresh magma stirred things up, it blurped up to 2 to 3 kilometers of lava. Odds are good that this will be the type of eruption that occurs next at Yellowstone rather than the rare super eruption. They think it'll be a small eruption. Fortunately, the researchers write any significant rejuvenalization of the reservoir is likely to be associated with deformation or seismicity, earthquakes, swarms, and any identifiable by geophysical monitoring. We should have a useful amount of warning that something angry is brewing down in Yellowstone volcanic guts, just not as much of a warning we would like. Another paper I found about this, the region's most recent caldera-forming eruption, 640,000 years ago, created a 35-mile-wide, 50-mile-long Yellowstone caldera. Pyroclastic flows from this eruption left thick volcanic deposits known as the Lava Creek Tuff, which can be seen in the south-facing cliffs east of Madison River, where they form the north wall of the caldera. Huge volumes of volcanic ash were blasted high into the atmosphere, and deposits of this ash can still be found in places as distant from Yellowstone as Iowa, Louisiana, and California. Since its last cataclysmic volcanic eruption about 640,000 years ago, the Yellowstone region has had about 40 eruptions of slow-moving lava flows of rhyolite, the most explosive type of lava you can possibly have. Some of these flows cover more than 100 square miles, and many are very thick, like this approximately 180,000-year-old rhyolite flow exposed at Obsidian Cliff. Although no lava has erupted at Yellowstone for 70,000 years, future such eruptions like this is likely to occur. And there's the lava. So going to Google Earth, here we have Lava Creek Tuff. We got Sheep Eaters Cliff. And somewhere over here is Obsidian Cliffs. I don't see it. Over here is Maple Creek. Over here is Hedgin Lake. This is the area of the recent earthquakes. Majority of them. I'll show you. And I'm still looking for Obsidian Cliff. Madison River down here. And yeah, this is the area where the uplift is going on. And if you look at the ground formation, yeah, it's very interesting, isn't it? Here we have an aerial view of the striking northwest rim of Yellowstone Caldera. And the intra-caldera rhyolite lava flows at the Madison Junction in Yellowstone National Park. The view is looking north, the steep-facing caldera wall, 500 meters tall, formed when the area in the foreground collapsed during the eruption of the Lava Creek Tuff 640,000 years ago. The thick West Yellowstone rhyolite flow erupted about 110,000 years ez. And the Nez Perce Creek flow erupted about 160,000 years ez. So we got the caldera, Yellowstone Rim, the West Yellowstone Flow, the Nez Perce Creek Flow. And they have 10 earthquakes listed in the last week within this area. But actually within this area right here, they're only listing 6. Anyways, we'll go to all the earthquakes. Most of them there have been in the Maple Creek area of the chart that I have. We got Yellowstone Lake. The borehole for Madison River, which also shows the same quakes as what Maple Creek does. And then this is Lake Butte. So this has 5 earthquakes for today, just today alone. Not for the whole week. This is 5 for today. All 5 are marked in red, meaning the computer picked it up, sent a message to the geologist. This one is not marked in red, but it's an earthquake. We'll look at the signature. Yeah, volcanic tremors. Let's take another look at this one right here. Yeah, harmonic and volcanic tremors. Take a look at the spectrogram. Again, this is for Maple Creek. And there's that one. Yeah, volcanic tremors. Take a look at this one. That one is volcanic tremors. And then we'll take a look at this one up here marked in red. Not being reported. The largest looks like this one. at 1558. That lasted a really long time. You can see the harmonic tremors. I noticed, too, at Yellowstone Lake, there was an earthquake that really shook up the caldera for a long time. I think it's right... let me see if I can find it. Right there. Yeah. And it lasted a long time for how it just reverberated across... yeah, the lake. I'll bring it down because it's hard to see. Just exactly where the line is at. And then we got another one, it looks like, somewhere in there. Yeah, these are all harmonic tremors. But that's the only one I saw at Yellowstone Lake. Yeah, look at the hot gases coming up, the hot water. Might be easier to see it if I go up here. This here. Right here, the second line from the top, that's Yellowstone Lake. And I'll go back about 4 hours, see how it was just really shaking up. And I'll bring it over. And we'll go back another 4 hours. Right there. Okay, there it is. I'll extract that for you. Right there. 1609. Not being reported, and it shows up. The top one here is Madison River. This here is Yellowstone Lake. This here is Maple Creek that I pulled it from. And then down here at the bottom, that one is Lake Butte. Yeah, not being reported. And then we got, yeah, more. So, Lava Creek Tuff was the last area to erupt. And it's looking like with the uplift that's going on, may not be a lot, but yeah, it probably wouldn't take a lot for Yellowstone to erupt. I don't know. We gotta keep an eye on that area. Here we have a current view of Old Faithful. Yeah, snow on the ground. So what are your thoughts? Put your comments down below. Thank you for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Thank you very much for your support. Please stay safe. And I'll talk to you later. God bless you all. Bye.